बी This is 12 volt. This is also 12 volt. This is A here. This is B here. Question is, okay, so I'll just wait for a minute and then I will start. Okay, so it's time. Here is a question. This is apparently question number 25. Question number 25 in H.C. Verma, a chapter on capacitors. Okay, so I too have an H.C. Verma. In my H.C. Verma, this is not 12 volts. This is 24 volts. Okay, in my H.C. Verma, this is not 12 volts. This is 24 volts. But anyway, assume this is the correct question and we want to answer this. Okay. So let us first understand. Let us first understand that any one of them to be the driver cell. So let us assume this is the driver cell. If this is the driver cell, this is going to drive some charge on this side. Suppose it is plus Q here. So if it is plus Q here, it has to be minus Q here. If it is minus Q here, it will be plus Q here and it will be minus Q here. Okay. So now my circuit is complete. Okay. Now if my circuit is complete, I'll go in this particular loop and then I will apply Kirchhoff's law. Yeah. So let me go start from here and then I will terminate here. So I'm going like this. So I'm going from the negative to the positive. So when I'm going from negative to positive, I will gain. Okay. So I will gain. So what is the gain that I have? C is equal to Q by V. So V will become equal to Q by C. So it will become Q divided by 2 into 10 power minus 6. Then again, when I'm going from negative to positive, again I will gain. So I'll gain 12 volt. Now I'm going from negative to positive. So now when I'm going from negative to positive, again I'll gain. So plus Q divided by 4 into 10 power minus 6. Now when I'm going from positive to negative, I will lose. So these are all the gains, and then the loss will be equal to 12. Yeah, so this is what I will get. So if this is what I get, then this is gain. Whenever I go from negative to positive, I gain. Whenever I go from negative to positive battery also, again negative to positive. So this is correct, this is correct, this is correct. This is equal to 12 volts. So now very simply, what will you do? You will cancel these two. Now once you cancel these two, this is equal to zero. If this is equal to zero, Q is equal to zero. Okay, so that is how you will go ahead with it initially. Now let us see in the corrected question. In the corrected question, they changed it to 24. So if they change it to 24, now this will, instead of being 12, it will become 24. So now if it is 24, then Q by 2 into 10 power minus 6 plus Q by 4 into 10 power minus 6 is equal to 12 volt. So now I can do some LCM business and get the value for Q. Once I get the value for Q, then I can say that I am at VB. I am at VB. Then when I'm going from negative to positive, I am going to gain something, Q by 2 into 10 power minus 6. And then I will reach the potential at A. So now the question is, what is VB minus or VA minus VB? Take it to the other side. You will get VA minus VB is equal to Q by 2 into 10 power minus 6. Can you just follow it up and then get it? If I do it right, I think I will get it is equal to 8 volt. How did I say that quickly without doing it? Okay, so if this is equal to V, this is equal to V, this will become equal to 2V. So 3V is equal to, suppose Q by 2 represents V, then Q by 4 will represent V by 2. So 3V by 2, I cancel it. So I get V is equal to 8. So I get it is equal to 8. Am I clear? The first question, 12 volt, Q will be 0. Second question, if you make it 24, then you will get 8 volts as the answer. Yeah? So think about it. Huh? Okay, so if you all understood, then let me move out. You can use an app called Notably instead of using it on the browser. This is the second lag when you use the browser, but not the case with Notability. It will ease for us coming along with you. Oh, I don't know. What is this Notability? Yeah, I will teach from Daniel's cell only. But now this is understood. What I did now, is this screen visible or no? Yes, screen is visible. About this Notability, my dear friend, I will... First step, draw a diagram. Second step, suppose on this side a positive going, this side negative must be going. If this side negative is going, this side must be positive, this side must be negative. So I am not saying A, B, nothing. First, I just wrote my simple equation. After writing my equation, I found out the value for Q. I explained to you if it is 12 volt, question is wrong or answer is zero. then actually they have changed in my book. It is 24. So when I put 24, I will get this equation. Once I get this equation, I have found the value for Q. Okay. Now I am going from my journey from this point to this point. I am going in my journey from B to A. So I am at VB, whatever is the potential. Then I went from negative to positive. So I gained. So I got Q by 2 into 10 power minus 6. And I reached A. So if I reached A, again I lost. I didn't lose. I reached A. So when I went from B to A, this is the equations that I have. Now the question is, what is VA minus VB? So you take it to the other side, you will get 2 into 10 power minus 6. VA is the potential at A and VB is the potential at B. Okay? Yeah. Then let us move on. So today I am going to discuss about electrochemical cell. This electrochemical cell is the battery that I go outside and buy. Okay. Now in the year 1800 or around the 1800, first thing is, please understand that science is not the contribution of one person. Many people contributed. Many people contributed. Okay. But this particular contribution, that is to the of the cell, mostly goes to this scientist Volta. So now I'll explain to you about the first cell which was made. Basically, 1 minute. Audio and video is not synchronizing. VB is the potential at a point B. VA is the potential at a point A. Okay. Veetlendu na kalambi irken. I have some money with me. I went to some place. After that, I had some more money. So how much money did I earn or spend? Starting money minus final money. So that is what we are doing. Ranjit, are you there?
Yes,
yeah,
sir.
Now only chat I am showing.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, is there any problem with the screen?
For me, it is okay, sir.
Okay. I am writing something. That's tell me what I am writing.
Yeah, ampere.
Okay. Then again, now tell me.
Daniel cell.
Okay, friends, I will look at that notability and all. There are two things. If there is a problem at my end, there will be a problem for everyone. Okay, but if there are problems at your end, there will be...
Yeah, some network problem at particular place. It's because of that, I guess.
Particular place, not, yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah. Yeah. So, bear with me, and then at the end of it, let me know you understood, not understood. I will make a video and send. Okay, so that way it will be the best. Yeah, so let us just move on. Okay. Yeah, so around the 1800, what people realized is that it is possible for us to create a device which can enable current to pass in a circuit. Okay, such a device is what is referred to as an electrochemical cell. Now you will read about electrochemical cell in chemistry. We don't need to know it, but I am just telling you some basics because I know it, so I am telling you. I don't have to tell you, but I can tell you. First thing is a cell. A cell, basically what happens in a cell is a chemical reaction takes place. Okay. A chemical reaction takes place. Now, what is the chemical reaction in this particular case? In case of a Daniel cell, you have copper sulfate. To copper sulfate, you are going to add zinc. So what will happen is zinc sulfate and copper will be formed. Okay. Now, see, copper sulfate is a salt which is soluble in water. So when it is soluble in water, copper sulfate will not exist as copper sulfate. It will exist as Cu2 plus plus SO4 2 minus plus you are adding zinc. Again, zinc sulfate is a soluble salt. So it will give Zn2 plus plus SO4 2 minus plus copper. Okay. Now on this side I have SO4 2 minus. On this side also I have SO4 2 minus. So I can simply cancel them. So what is the reaction that is taking place? The reaction that is taking place is an electron exchange reaction between copper and zinc, where copper 2 plus plus zinc forms zinc 2 plus plus copper. Okay, now when we measure the potential difference, the potential difference is 1.41. And this potential difference is not dependent on the amount of the substance. Okay, this potential difference is only dependent on the nature of the reactants. That is, what are the reactants? So what now scientists did is they kind of separated this. So here what is happening is copper 2 plus is gaining 2 electrons to form copper. Then you have zinc, which is losing 2 electrons to form zinc 2 plus. Okay, so loss of electrons means what? Oxidation is taking place. Gain of electrons means what? Reduction is taking place. And the electrons lost is equal to the electrons gained. So now what the people did is, instead of allowing both of them to happen in the same container, they kind of physically separated the two. When they separated the two, they ensured that the movement of electron can happen only in the external circuit. And that is what a cell is. A cell supplies us an EMF. Okay. And the amount of current is a property of the amount of substance. So the amount of current depends upon the amount of substance. Okay, so the amount of current depends upon the amount of substance, and a battery simply supplies us current. Now, if you buy a battery, there will be a fixed potential difference between the two ends. Now we have a 3 volt battery available easily. We have 1.5 volt batteries available easily, and so on. In all these cases, what happens is there are electrons which are moving in the external circuit, but even in the internal circuit, some ions are moving some distance. Now, because of that, a cell has internal resistance. A cell has internal resistance. This internal resistance of a cell is again proportional to rho L by A, where rho depends upon the nature of the electrolyte. So in the reaction that I told you, on one side copper 2 plus is moving, on the other side zinc 2 plus is moving. Yeah, so these ions are moving. Now you can have lithium hydrogen batteries. In lithium hydride batteries, you have lithium moving and you have hydrogen moving. Now you see there's a difference between the size. So they will have different resistivities. So resistivity is a property of the nature of the electrolyte. Then it also depends upon the distance between electrodes. The distance between electrodes. Now, larger the distance, more the electrolyte has to travel. So, greater the resistance. And it also depends upon the area of the electrode. It also depends upon the area of the electrode. Now, greater the area, lesser will be the resistance. Why? Because if I dip a greater part of it, reaction can happen at all these points. But if I just dip a small part of it, reaction can happen only here. So here definitely more reaction will happen. So here more current will be there. More current means lesser resistance. So the cell, the internal resistance of a cell depends upon, one, the nature of the electrolyte. Two, it depends upon the distance between electrodes. And three, it depends upon the area of the electrodes. Okay, so we have to understand R is equal to rho L by A. We will learn this in detail when we do chemistry. Okay, but what we will remember that, look, there is a battery. That battery has a fixed potential difference. There's a positive terminal, there's a negative terminal. It has a fixed potential difference between two ends. That fixed potential difference is called the EMF of the cell. EMF stands for electromotive force. That is the force with which the electrons are driven from one side to the other side. The greater the force, greater will be the number of electrons moving, so larger will be the current. Larger will be the current. Can you please make some notes here? Can you quickly make some notes? Okay, so just give me 1 minute. Sir, but what causes internal resistance? Internal resistance is the resistance to motion. The electron, they will collide with each other. Positives are moving, so they'll collide with each other. So there will be some repulsion. So there will be internal resistance. When you move around in a class, there will be internal resistance. Okay, sir, does the cell's potential difference gradually reduce? Where everywhere batteries are. So if we connect a voltmeter across the battery, will it? It won't reduce significantly. Okay, see, this potential difference depends only on the nature of the reaction. It doesn't depend upon the. I mean, it depends on the extent of the reaction, but it depends to a very small extent on the extent. It depends to a large extent on the nature of the reaction. So, for a given cell, for a given reaction, the internal resistance is fixed. So, if you go for a given reaction, the EMF is fixed. Okay. Chemistry class happened today. Examples where ideal batteries are used. There are no ideal batteries. Everywhere there will be internal resistance. But they are trying to reduce resistance, but that is not a big deal because, you know, but everywhere batteries are being used. So I explained to you, if you connect a battery, if you connect a voltmeter across a battery which is being used, its potential will keep decreasing to a small extent. Say, for example, if you go and buy a 1.5 volt battery, it will decrease up to maybe 1.4, 1.3. But after that, it will just stop working. Internal resistance. Internal means adhikulla. Resistance is resistance. So adhikulla irka resistance. Uppan ninga veetukulla ninga sutthuvingana adhila resistance irukum. Adhu, that is your internal resistance. Veli vanda inno resistance varu. Adhu outside external resistance. So inside the battery, the resistance to the flow movement of charge carriers is called internal resistance. Okay. So does it mean that every battery has internal resistance? Yes, every battery has internal resistance. Oh, no. Chemistry class is there after this. I'm sorry. Yeah. Okay. So I answered all your questions. Fine. Okay, good. So now let us move on. So what we know now is that there is a battery, and whenever there is a battery, there is an internal resistance. Okay, so this is the battery. The long line represents the positive terminal. The short line represents the negative terminal. So this is how a battery is represented. Now next to the battery, I put a small R, meaning that that battery has internal resistance R. Okay, then I write EMF, I write E1. So E1 is the EMF of the battery. Okay, now suppose I connect one battery to one resistor, capital R. Okay, I connect one battery to one resistor, capital R. So now what will be the current in the circuit? The current in the circuit will be E1 divided by total resistance, R plus R. So this will be the current in the circuit. If this is the current in the circuit, suppose I write Kirchhoff's law in this particular loop, do you see that I can say E minus IR minus I into capital R is zero? Now, do you see that E minus IR is equal to I into capital R? Now, what is this E minus IR? Now, you see, this is the battery. This is all in one enclosure. So, what is this E minus IR? Suppose I have a point A here, I have a point B here, and I have VA and I have VB. So, E minus IR is VA minus VB. VA minus VB, that is the potential difference. That is the potential difference between the two ends of the battery. So, for a battery, there are two things. One is the EMF, which is equal to E1. Second is the potential difference, which is equal to E1 minus IR. Now, always EMF will be greater than V, except when I is equal to 0. So, when I is equal to 0, we say it's an open circuit. Okay, so the potential difference between the terminals of a battery in open circuit is called EMF. The potential difference between the terminals of a battery is called EMF. Sorry, in open circuit. The potential between the terminals of a battery in open circuit. In open circuit is called EMF. When EMF potential becomes EMI is equal to 0. Okay, now what will be the potential difference? This is I is equal to E1 R by R plus R. So it is equal to E1 into R by R plus R. So do you see that it will be a small fraction? It will be a fraction. The potential difference across the battery, the effective potential difference across the battery will be a fraction of its EMF. Yeah. So can you please make notes and reach up to here? Please draw the circuit. Many of you are not drawing circuits in your exams. Then I've requested you guys to correct your papers and put it. Not only some 9, 10, 11 of you have put it so far. So when can I expect the others to finish the job? Yes, so many of you have not yet submitted that. Please do that. If you do it, I'll give you your marks immediately. Okay. So, I hope you have made notes. So, the total potential is greater than the, is less than the cell EMF. It can't be greater, it is less. Is EMF, if EMF is basically a fixed potential difference, yes, it's a, like a calculated value. My calculated, if you give me 10 spoons of glucose, ideally I will run for 100 meters. But if you give me 10 spoon, I may not be able to run 100 meters. I may be able to run 90 meters and then fall. Yes, you have. You have chemistry class after physics class. Is EMF basically a fixed potential difference? Kind of. So the total potential is always less than the cell EMF. Not greater than. It is always less than. Okay, so I'm sorry, please don't ask me about these chemistry classes and all. I don't want you to talk about chemistry class right now. Okay, your chemistry, your schedule has not got changed. Nothing has changed. Everything is the same. Today, maths class, we were not able to conduct. So please don't ask me about chemistry class. Don't tell me about chemistry class. I am not that person to tell you anything. I am sorry, there is no nothing about. After this, I don't know anything. If it is there in a regular schedule, it is there. So I don't know about anything. So please don't ask me about chemistry class. I am sorry. Let us talk about potential if you want to. Otherwise, let me know. We will stop this class also so that you all can relax. Okay. Yeah. So done. So now. So you have a cell. If you have a cell, it has an internal resistance and I have connected it to an external resistance capital R. This is internal resistance and this is the battery that I am talking of. So this battery will drive, will give rise to some current and the current in the circuit is equal to E divided by R plus R. The potential difference across the external resistance R is equal to E into capital R by R plus R. Okay, now what does a battery do? What does a battery do? A battery basically supplies current. It supplies current, which depends upon the quantity of substance. Okay. Then it supplies current at a potential, at some EMF. Now this EMF is also fixed for a given reaction. Okay, so a lithium ion battery has a particular EMF. Daniell cell has a particular EMF. A Leclanche cell has a particular EMF. Every cell, a lead acid battery has a particular EMF. Every cell has a particular EMF. And the amount of current that it gives, it depends upon the quantity of the substance. Okay. Now, when a current I passes through a resistor R, there is a power drop or there is a power supplied. Okay, and the power is equal to I squared R. Power is equal to I squared R. Power basically is the rate of doing work inside a resistor. That rate of doing work will become equal to dq by dt into V, the potential difference. So it will become I into V. V itself is equal to I into R. So it is equal to I squared R. So this I squared R is the power loss across a resistor. When a current I passes through a resistor R, the power loss is equal to I squared R. Okay. Now in this case also there is a power loss. So that power loss, who's giving that power? The battery is giving that power. So the power supplied by a battery is equal to I squared R. So it will become E square capital R plus small r the whole squared into R. Now this is the power supplied by the battery. Okay. So now sometimes I can ask a question. What is the maximum power supplied by the battery? Or when is the power supplied by the battery maximum? So for that to be maximum minimum, there has to be some variable. So what is the variable in this? E is not a variable. R is not a variable. So the only variable is R. That means if I keep changing the external resistance, I can find out a condition when the power delivered by a particular battery is maximum. So for that, what do? I take the power, find out dp by dt is equal to zero, and find out the condition. Can you do the same and find out the condition when dp by dt is equal to zero? Can you quickly find it out? So the differentiate it with respect to R. Yeah. So if you have made notes, I will differentiate it with respect to R. Today, I'm not going to show you snapshots, screenshots. I'm not going to allow you. Okay. So you want to write, you write notes. Yeah. So the power supplied by the battery is equal to E squared R by capital R plus small r the whole squared. So now this is the power supplied. My condition, I'm asking you, under what condition will a power supplied by the battery be maximum? So for that, I am saying the regular standard method is to first understand what is the variable and then make sure that dp by dr, not dt, dp by dr, the power is equal to maximum. So for that, dp by dr should be equal to zero. So now differentiate it with respect to R and then you will get the equate it to zero, you will get the condition. Can you quickly work it out? Okay, so this is the fourth slide. This is the fifth slide. And now I want you to differentiate it. You have E squared R by R plus small r the whole squared. Now you want to find out D by dr equal to zero. So it will become equal to E square into R plus R the whole squared into one minus two R into two times R plus R divided by R plus R the whole power 4 is equal to 0. Now this gets cancelled, this gets cancelled. So this must be equal to 0. So you will get R plus R the whole squared is equal to 2 times R into R plus R. So this and this gets cancelled. So from there you will get small r is equal to capital R. That means when the external resistance equals the internal resistance, when the external resistance equals the internal resistance, the power delivered, power delivered by a cell is maximum. The power delivered by a cell is maximum. Okay, so this is what you have to understand. This is a 2-mark question in your board exam. So under what condition will the power delivered by a cell be maximum? So the power delivered by a cell will be maximum when the external resistance equals the internal resistance of the cell. Then the power delivered by a cell will be maximum. Okay, so I am differentiating with respect to dr. So the differential of r is 1, so p by q. So I have used p by q and then found out the resistance. Okay. So I am explaining again. In a circuit like this, this is the battery and this is R, this is small r, this is E. So the current in the circuit I will become E divided by small r plus capital R. How did I get that? I wrote Kirchhoff's laws. So when I wrote Kirchhoff's laws, I got E gain in potential minus I into R minus I into small r is equal to 0, or E is equal to I into capital R plus small r, or E divided by capital R plus small r is equal to I. Okay, now power is equal to I squared R. So the power is equal to E squared by R plus R the whole squared into R. This is the power delivered. Power delivered. So this much work is happening per second in the resistor. This much work is happening per second in the resistor. So if this is the work happening in the resistor, I am asking when is the power delivered the maximum? When is the power delivered by the cell a maximum? So for which I am saying power delivered will be maximum when dp by dr is equal to 0. Because r is the only variable, everything else is fixed. So I am going to differentiate it. Now differentiation, you have to learn it. I am differentiating p by q, first function, into differential of numerator. Differential of numerator is 1. Into the q function denominator minus numerator into differential of the denominator 2 times r plus r. Now this is equal to 0, condition for maximum. So these two must be equal. This is also e squared. So the e square gets cancelled. R plus r, this gets cancelled. So I'll get r plus r is equal to 2 times capital R. So 1r gets cancelled. So I'll get small r is equal to capital R. Under this condition, the power delivered by the cell is the maximum. So when is the power delivered by the cell maximum? Power delivered by the cell is maximum when small r is equal to capital R. That is, the internal resistance is equal to external resistance. Okay, so this is a 2-mark question. These are 3-mark question also. So please make out and make sure that you are learning this correctly. Okay, it has come as 2 marks. It has come as 3 marks also. Now let's move on. Now here I have one cell. It's internal resistance. I have another cell. It's internal resistance. I have another cell. It's internal resistance. Let this be E1. Let this be E2. Let this be E3. Let this be R1, let this be R2, let this be R3. Okay, Now, suppose I am at a point here. Let me call this A. Suppose I am at a point here. Let me call this B. Suppose this is VA potential here. Suppose this is VB. I want to know what is the potential difference between A and B. So I start with VA. When I'm going from positive to negative, I lose potential. So minus E1. Because the circuit is incomplete, there cannot be any current. So again, when I'm moving from E2, again I lose potential because I'm going from positive to negative. Again, I'm losing potential when I'm going across E3. And when I reach this, I reach VB. So VA minus VB is equal to E1 plus E2 plus E3. That means when cells are connected in series, the EMF is equal to sum of EMF. So why do you want to connect cells in series? Suppose a particular system will run at a 3-volt potential. But you have only 2 batteries available at 1.5 volt. So when you connect them in series, the net potential difference will become 3 volts. So cells are connected in series to increase the potential. Cells are connected in series to increase the potential. Cells are connected in series to increase the potential. When the potential increases, automatically the internal resistance also increases because they are all in series. So R becomes R1 plus R2 plus R3. So when cells are connected in series, the potential increases, the internal resistance also increases. Okay, can you quickly make some notes here? So why do we say only energy is used up in the circuit and not current? And current is used means electrons are used. But at the battery, inside the battery, unless the electron goes to the other side, circuit will not be complete, or the reaction will not be complete. So without reaction completeness, you won't get energy. So the reaction has to be completed. So electrons are not consumed in the cell. It is only the energy in this is consumed in the cell. Why do we say that is the condition? Condition, you have to learn calculus. In calculus, you will learn for any function to be maximum, dP by dR must be 0. Okay, any calculation, maximum dP by dR must be 0. If there is a curve of this kind, that means it is becoming maximum here. If it is maximum here, means what? Tangent is parallel to the x-axis. Tangent is parallel means what? Slope is equal to 0. Slope is equal to 0 means what? dF by dx is equal to 0. So that is what we are also using, maximum for, that's a condition for any function, any variable to be maximum. It is not just the condition for maximum, even for minimum, that is what it is. For minimum also, at that tip, the slope will be parallel to the x-axis. Slope is parallel means dy by dx is 0. For any function, dy by dx will give you the slope. So you're trying to find out when is the slope equal to 0. Okay, now let's focus here. Make sure that you have understood this part. If you have understood this part, we will move on. So energy is used up only because electrons can't be used. Electrons are required. So 2 electrons from zinc will complete the full circuit and go to 2 electrons in copper. Only then the reaction will be complete. Otherwise, it won't be complete. Okay, so if this is done, our job is done. So I explained to you why cells are connected in series and you are writing it down. That is again a 3-mark question. Why are cells connected in series and parallel? So they are connected in series to increase the EMF. Don't write that they are connected in series to increase the internal resistance. We never want to increase the internal resistance. Okay, we always want to decrease the internal resistance. So we never want to connect them in connect them to increase the internal resistance. Okay, so if this job is done, then let's move on. Now here we are having cells in parallel. So this is R1. Suppose this is the battery. This is again R1 and it is the same battery. Suppose this is R1, again same battery. Okay, so now suppose I have connected this across external resistance capital R. So now what is going to happen? So do you see this is E1, this is E1, this is E1. Now do you see that this is a closed loop? So in this closed loop, can I say that I1 is equal to E1 by small r plus capital R? Okay, the current, okay, see, okay, let me do it more systematically. No problem, I understand. You will have difficulty understanding this. So let me do it systematically. See, this, let this current be I1. This is I1. This is I. Let this current be I2. Let this current be I3. Okay. Now, what is happening is here, the current is becoming I1 plus I2 plus I3. Okay. So, do you see that when you have a parallel connection, do you see when you have a parallel connection, I is increasing? Huh? The internal, the current because of each cell is getting added up. So we connect resistors in parallel to increase the current in the circuit. We connect cells in parallel to increase the current in the circuit. Then we connect cells in parallel. Also now you see all these resistors have become in parallel. So if you have 3 internal resistors in parallel, 1 by R effective will become equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So that will become R1 equal to R2 will become 3 by R3, R1. So that means what? R effective will become equal to R1 by 3. So when you connect cells in series, the internal resistance decreases. I'm sorry, when you connect cells in parallel, the internal resistance decreases. The potential will remain the same. Potential will remain the same. But because of contribution from each cell, the current increases. Or this particular current, whatever is the current here, is I/3 from here, I/3 from here, and I/3 from here. Okay, so there are more number of cells which are giving the same amount of current here. So if the potential is E1, so I'm not sure if you guys are thinking and if you are able to understand. Let me see. So please think, what I'm trying to say is, if only one battery is there, suppose only this one was there, only one battery supplying all the current. If this one is there, now 2 batteries are going to supply the current. If 3 batteries are there, 3 batteries will be supplying the same current. So the current supplied by each of them is going to get added on. I have made a wrong statement here. Current is increasing is a wrong statement. Current remains the same. Just that the current is being developed, is contributed partly by each of those cells. So the internal resistance decreases. Okay, it is the contribution from each cell, the current appears to be increasing, current doesn't increase. The current is getting distributed. Okay, see, the potential difference across this is E only. So E by R will be the, or V by R will be the current, whatever you do. Now, what is this V equal to? V equal to E minus, this will become I by 3. I by 3 small r by capital R. Okay, so the current delivered by each battery will now become 1/3. If you have 3 batteries, if you have 10 batteries, the current delivered by each battery will become 1/10. Because the current is 1/10, the internal resistance also becomes 1/10. Or the energy loss because of internal resistance is 1/10. But the current in the external circuit remains the same. Whether you have 1 battery, 2 battery, 3 battery, 10 batteries, the current in the external circuit will remain the same. Because the potential difference here will be some V. So the current here will be V by R. There is no change in that current. Current in series is the same. Draw the circuit, the same current has to pass through all of them. So there also each battery is going to contribute. That is not an issue there. But there the potential difference is increasing. Because the potential difference is increasing, each battery is going to contribute. So if you have cells in series, suppose you have cells in series, suppose you have one in series. So now this will become 3V. If you have the external resistance here, so I will become equal to 3 times V divided by 3R plus capital R. So here what has happened? I has increased. So in series, if there was only one, it would have been V by R plus capital R. Now because 3 batteries are there, it will become 3V by this much. So in series circuit, the batteries contribute the same current. There is a small difference, so leave that. The same current, whether one is there, two is there, three is there, they all contribute the same current. So the current increases. In series, the current increases. In series, the potential also increases. The internal resistance also increases. Okay, in parallel, what happens is potential remains the same. Then internal resistance decreases. Then the current gets distributed. So contribution by each cell decreases. Okay, so contribution by each cell decreases. So this is what happens in series. This is what happens in parallel. Okay, so I hope series parallel, you all are getting it. Now, suppose I take M into N cells. Suppose I put M of them here. And then I have N rows like this. Excuse me. And I have M columns like this. Now, what will be the EMF of this? The EMF of this will be M into E. What will be the internal resistance of this? M into R. Because of this, what will be the EMF? Same, M into E. But what will be the internal resistance? Now it will become M into R by N. Okay. such a combination is what is referred to as a battery. A battery is not a single cell. We go to the market and ask for a battery, we are wrong. We can only buy a cell. A combination of cells gives you a battery. In a battery, you have a series and parallel connection. Why do you have a series connection? To increase the potential. But when you increase the potential, the internal resistance also increases. So what happens? So a lot of losses happen. So you connect a parallel set also. Why do you connect the parallel set? So that the internal resistance decreases. If internal resistance decreases, the loss will also decrease. So the life of the system will be longer. So that is why batteries are connected in series and parallel. Okay, batteries are connected in series and parallel. One, in series to increase the potential. But internal resistance also increases. When you connect a parallel row of cells, then what happens is potential remains the same. Now the internal resistance decreases. Yeah. So this combination of cells is what is referred to as a battery. You can see this very well outside the computer lab where they have arranged the batteries. So they have much bigger batteries. So they would have a set of batteries this way, and then they would have the same number of batteries, different rows. So now what this does is decreases the resistance. What this does is it increases the potential. So that is why you have a combination of batteries. Yeah, we will see if each battery has a different potential. We will see. If the same potential, we have seen. If there are different potentials, we will see how to do it. So potential difference remains the same. So if you have M of them, it will be M into E. Potential difference doesn't change because of different rows. Okay. So now suppose you have one battery here, E1, R1. And you have another battery here, E2, and you have R2. Suppose your points here, A, B. The question is, what is the potential difference? What is the potential difference? And internal resistance. Of this combination. Okay, what is the potential difference and internal resistance of this combination? Yeah, so I want to find out what is the internal resistance and potential difference of this combination. So let me see how I can work it out. Now, do you see that there are some batteries and then the circuit is complete here? The circuit here is complete. So now because the circuit is complete, if there is some current I here, there will be a current I here, I here, I here, I here, and it will keep going. Okay, so now I have this point here. Let me call that point VA. So now I will go from A to B along the top this. So I'll get VA. I'm going from positive to negative. So I'll be losing potential. Then I'm going against the current. So plus I into R1, and I have reached VB is equal to VB. I was at A, suppose the potential is A, VA. I went from positive to negative. Because I went from positive to negative, I lose potential. So minus E1. Then I'm going against the direction of current. Because I'm going against the direction of current, I'm going to gain potential. So I'll get VA minus E1 plus IR1 is equal to VB. Or I can say that VA minus VB is equal to E1 minus IR1. Okay, now I'm going through the lower loop. So again, I start at A and I go I2 plus same logic. But this time I'm going in the direction of current. Now, because I'm going in the direction of current, I'll be losing potential. So it will become IR2 is equal to VB. And I can write VA minus VB is equal to E2 minus IR2. Okay, now this VA minus VB is going to be the effective EMF. So I'll say E effective. So this is equal to E effective. So now I want to calculate what is E effective. So now to calculate E effective, I will try to eliminate R1. So I will multiply equation 1 with R2. I'll multiply equation 2 with R1. And then I will see what I can do. So I will get R2 E1 minus I R1 R2 is equal to E effective. I think this will become plus. I made an error there. Okay. Then I will get R1 E2 plus I R1 R2 is equal to E effective. So I am going to add them. So I'll get E effective is equal to R2 E1 plus R1 E2. Oh, this will be R2 R1 by R1 plus R2. Okay, so I will get E effective is equal to E2 E1 R2 plus E2 R1 by R1 plus R2. This is going to be the effective EMF. Now, because these two are in a parallel connection, the effective R internal resistance will become R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. Okay, if they are equal, if they are effective, if they are, those two are in parallel. If they are in parallel, they are in parallel. So effective, R effective is R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. Okay, so this is how you get when the two cells have different EMFs. This is a very, very important 3-mark question. This question has come many times in the JE mains. It has also come in the NEET exam. Many entrance exams, you can expect this question to come. Yeah, if all of you are having the same problem, I can understand. But Anirudh, I'm sorry, but only you are having the problem. I mean, not you. Some of you are only having the problem. All of you are not having this problem. But I will tell you one small thing. Yeah. I am typing it. I am not saying anything. I am only... I am not saying anything, okay? Chemistry class is already over. Huh? So there is another question which has come in your exam. See, in this case, both are positive. In this case, positive negative. So in this case, EMF is equal to E1 R2 minus E2 R1 Okay, so hey, I don't know. Yeah, please don't talk to me about schedule. I don't know. As per your regular class timings, all the classes are happening except for the maths class. Yeah, I've been typing it. Fine. So, no, do you have regular classes till 4? Your class ends at 3:30, so class is over. Yeah, okay, so I am done. I am slowly reaching the end of the portions. I will do some more questions, pending portions.